California Republican Kevin McCarthy is the House Majority Whip, and he joins me now. Good morning, Congressman McCarthy. Good to have you back.
Thanks for having me.
So what do you make of that? You heard Charles Krauthammer last night and reports this morning that basically the inaugural address was sort of an olive branch, but the 1-2 punch is coming tonight.
That's unfortunate. I was hoping that this president would realize the campaign is over and that he could put a plan together for all Americans that we can move forward and get this economy back working again.
Well, the plan is, according to what we're learning, through more spending, infrastructure, education, green energy. These are really themes that we have heard throughout the Obama presidency. What's your response going to be to, you know, the notion that, spending more is the way he still believes he's going to turn this economy around?
Well, that's going to fail because, remember, we've had this whole plan before where they went out, spent $1 trillion on a stimulus plan that did not work. It helped get us in this mess. And if you look, the president just wants to continue to take more from the American people and the workers. And that doesn't work. He's got more than enough revenues. He's always talked about a balanced approach, but he's never talked about the ability to where he could find cuts in government or control the spending of government. That's where he really needs to focus, and he really should put his political pressure on the Democrats in the Senate that haven't even produced a budget.
There's absolutely no indication in any of what we're learning so far about this address that, it does that. Everything is pointing to, in fact, you know, one of his aides was a source on one of these reports this morning, quoted an old Chinese military strategist from thousands of years ago who said, you know, the idea is to build your opponent a golden bridge to retreat across. That's the way he sees the GOP, that they have, you know, bucked him at every turn, and that he's not going to take it anymore. He's ready to, you know, move forward aggressively without you guys.
Well, that's wrong. That's not what the American public wants. They want to see people work together. And you know what? You know what's the saddest part of this? Normally, during divided government, we achieve big things. Remember, when Ronald Reagan was president, the Democrats controlled both House, and they reformed the tax code. When Bill Clinton lost the House and had Newt Gingrich and Bob Dole to deal with, they balanced the budget, and they reformed welfare. That's the model this president should go after, not this continual campaigning. I think Americans want to see us work together, and that's what the House has been doing.
You know, one of the tricky things with this tax reform issue that I see is that early on in the process of trying to come up with a way to bring in some more revenue, Republicans said, you know, we're willing to do that. We'd like to do it through tax reform. We'd like to eliminate some of the loopholes. You know, we're even, you know, interested in talking about capital gains, all of that, but not raising the tax rate. But, you know, they sort of got you because they raised the tax rate initially as part of the fiscal cliff bargain. Now they're coming back for more and saying, you know, we also want what you guys suggested the first time around.
Yeah, but see, the numbers just don't add up. If you read the Congressional Budget Office latest report, over the last 4 decades, the average amount of money that the president got coming in was 17.9% of GDP. It says this president is going to get 19.1%, is going to take from the economy from the GDP. So he already has more revenue on average than the last 40 years. His problem is spending. If you just look at the first 2 months,
I don't think so, though.
You
heard from
year?
Nancy Pelosi. She says spending's not the problem. The president has said it. I should point out that their economist, Gene Sperling, this morning on Fox and Friends, said, we do recognize that spending is a problem. That's not how the president feels. He said, in fact, we've cut spending $1.2 trillion. You know, we're going there. We've already made those cuts, and we're willing to make more. What do you say?
I think the president continues to spend more. He added $6 trillion. If you just take the first 2 months of this fiscal year, revenues increased 10%, $30 billion. But spending increased 16%, $87 billion. You can't get out of this problem.
Do you feel like you're shouting into the wind, though? I mean, I didn't mean to just cut you off there, which makes you feel more like you're shouting into the wind. But, you know, do you feel that way?
Well, I feel frustrated that the president won't listen to the American public because, you know, everybody talks in trillions and tries to lose the American public. If you just take away all the zeros and put it in a family household numbers, on average, we bring in $24,000 a year, but we spend approximately $35,000. So we add $11,000 to the credit card. But on that credit card, we already owe $160,000. So you can't get out of this mess by continuing to spend. You have to grow the economy, which is a plan that we both worked together, but you got to watch your spending. That's when the president talks about a balanced approach. He should actually do something about it.
You know, when you talk about spending, you talk about adding things like infrastructure and green jobs and education, but you also talk about entitlement reform, which the president says he's willing to do. Do you see any common ground on entitlement reform coming in the course of this year?
Look, I see the American public wants to be able to save Medicare and Social Security, but I see the president ignoring it. And every year he ignores it, it adds $11 trillion to the unfunded. That is actually killing Medicare and Social Security. Where the Republicans put in a budget, a plan to balance the budget in 10 years, where the Democrats don't even offer one. And you know the most ironic thing tonight? They're going to have Apple's CEO inside the State of the Union. The last time the Senate Democrats passed a budget, the iPad wasn't even introduced. They're already on to their third version.
Oh, that's an interesting bit of trivia. Boy, thank you so much, Congressman Kevin McCarthy. It's always good to have you on America's Newsroom. Thanks, sir. Have a good day.
Thanks for having me.